If Bakugo has verbal tics, they're either indecipherable from the way he normally speaks, or so fucking bizarre and out of place that like the entire room goes silent and there's no fucking in between. Like middle of class, Bakugo, like head shoots up and he just suddenly goes,
Uwu?
and he also definitely has just like wild physical tic. Like, this boy's house was baby-proofed from the time he was born up until he moved into the UA dorms. Like, Izuku definitely can't tell if all the times Bakugo knocked his books out of his hands were because of bullying or just because of a tic, because Bakugo slaps shit out of people's hands as a tic. If you have the audacity to place a cup or a bowl on a counter near him, that shit will end up on the floor. And the reason he was so excited to cook at the training camp was not because he's good at cooking, it's because somebody finally let him have a fucking knife. Dengeki Kaminari has Tourette's. And like, he has the kind that like, no mental filter, he'll just say shit, cause like, he doesn't wanna say shit, and therefore he has to say the shit. Like, whenever he's in a car, he'll just fucking mimic a GPS, like, especially when there's a body of water nearby, he'll just be like, turn left, like into the fucking lake, and he's almost gotten like four people to do it, and like three of the four people were Kiri, like every fucking time, and like Kiri doesn't even have a fucking GPS. And then Dengeki meets Bakugo. Katsuki, out of my fucking way extras, Bakugo. And Dengeki's like, wow, this is one angry motherfucker, and he says a lot of really fucking rude shit. I really hope that I don't repeat anything he says, especially not back to his face. So naturally, the first thing that Denki ever says to him is out of my fucking way extra, and then they just end up in like a 20-second feedback loop of just yelling die at each other.
Ochako hits people. Not on purpose, obviously, but like if someone stands close to her and they just have a face, she's like, you're gonna get fucking smacked, my guy. And it's like really surprising for a lot of people because she's like so sweet and round and cute looking, and then like someone will walk up to her and she'll just fucking karate chop them in the throat. And it gets like 50 times worse after she interns with Gunhead. She accidentally floats shit all the time, too, for sure. Usually people when she hits them. Sitting with her at lunch is also an experience. She just grabs handfuls of food. Like, it could be a bowl of ramen, and like her fist will be in your food. She usually ends up sitting like on the end of the table, and then Todoroki's next to her because he usually eats cold soba, so whenever she palms it, she doesn't burn herself. So I've kind of been putting off the Izuku Tourette's video. Not because I don't have any ideas, but because I just have too fucking many. They're all fucking scrambled up in my head and they won't come out coherently no matter how hard I try. So have some word vomit, I guess. If middle school for quirkless Izuku was a hard time, middle school for quirkless Izuku with Tourette's was fucking hell. A lot of times, if you have Tourette's, the thing you want to say the least or do the least is the thing you end up saying and doing. So for Izuku, this meant telling a lot of teachers and bullies to go fuck themselves, right to their faces. So he pretty much was just always getting the shit kicked out of him, and then also getting detention. The only person who actually believed that he had Tourette's was Bakugo, and Bakugo still bullied the shit out of him for, you know, other reasons. Because of all of this, Izuku's anxiety about his Tourette's fed into his Tourette's so much that he can't even go more than a few seconds without ticking somehow anymore.